Ron Johnson is a conspiracy theory peddling traitorous bigot who protects abusers and attacks science in order to gain more money and power than he already married into. But it gets worse. I will explain for the smart people. If you're an idiot, feel free to stop watching, and then predictably try to change the subject by engaging in intellectually dishonest whataboutism in the comments. First, the backstory that would make a Lannister look like a benevolent leader. For those who don't know who Ron Johnson is, count yourself lucky. That means he's never directly trampled on your rights, defended your abusers, advocated forcing you to give birth after your assault, indirectly caused the death of one of your loved ones, directly caused the death of one of your loved ones, or any of the other horrible things that he's done to people. But if voters keep giving him power, it's a matter of time before his draconian views affect your life too. Ron Johnson is a senator from Wisconsin, and a self-made businessman. If you consider someone who is appointed CEO of his wife's brother's company self-made, seriously. His brother-in-law's company, Packer, was funded by Jane Johnson's rich father. Weird that Ron Johnson is so against handouts when his entire life has been one. After making a fortune by putting in the hard work to marry rich, Johnson entered into politics in 2010 by self-funding his campaign. Kind of. The $9 million he spent of his own money was magically covered when, a year later, Packer mysteriously paid him $10 million in deferred compensation. Who determined how much that deferred compensation was? He did. Johnson said that as CEO, determining his own compensation was completely up to him, and the similarity to how much he spent on his own campaign was merely coincidence. Sure, and Wisconsin winters are mild. Since Johnson has been elected, he's been a hypocritical nightmare. Actually, it started even before he was elected. In early 2010, Johnson testified before the Wisconsin Senate against a bill that would remove the deadline for child abuse victims to sue. Who would possibly be against that? Johnson's reasoning was that he wants to, and I quote, rid our society of people who prey on children. But allowing victims to sue without a deadline would financially cripple, and I quote, honorable organizations that do so much good for our communities. So Johnson says he wants to rid our society of predators, but not the organizations that shield them. Once in office, Johnson's hypocrisy was as obvious as a CEO who pays himself back for his own campaign. At first, Johnson was all about getting rid of the filibuster in order to, and I quote, ensure a quicker pace on Trump's court picks. Of course, Johnson changed his stance on that when he blocked a Biden nominee, the very same nominee that Johnson had previously recommended, because Ron Johnson has all the consistency of a Comcast internet connection. Johnson said he was a supporter of codifying same-sex marriage into federal law, and then he reversed his stance on that. Johnson recently claimed that he only said he supported codifying same-sex marriage into federal law to get the media, quote, off my back, and that the Obergefell case that allowed same-sex marriage was, quote, wrongfully decided. But if you thought that same-sex marriage was the only issue where Johnson displays his bigotry, well, you haven't been paying attention. But I'll get to that bigotry in a bit. First, more terrible platforms and policy. Johnson voted against marijuana legalization. He doesn't believe in climate change, and has touted the white supremacist conspiracy theory of, quote, the Great Replacement. And speaking of replacing things, Johnson called for the end of our Social Security and Medicare programs, wants to remove mandatory insurance coverage for pre-existing conditions, and even wants to get rid of the federal minimum wage. Johnson supports banning abortion, even in the case of rape, and advocates for jailing doctors who perform abortions. Remember, this is the same guy who wanted to shield organizations who shield child abusers, because they do so much good for our communities. But he also wants to jail rape victims and doctors. Johnson went from downplaying COVID-19 to outright lying about it. Everything from saying that mouthwash kills COVID to claiming that athletes were dying from vaccinations on field. Johnson even claimed that Pfizer's vaccine was not FDA approved. That is as big of a lie as saying that Ron Johnson came into his money through hard work and self-determination. And before I highlight Ron Johnson's bigotry and hypocrisy when it comes to January 6th, I have to explain Johnson's role in January 6th. Ron Johnson was a key figure in the attempted coup to subvert democracy. Johnson tried to personally give Mike Pence a list of fraudulent electors. There's proof of this. A text thread between Johnson and Pence's aides. Johnson even later hired one of those fake electors. Of course, when asked about the fake elector scheme, Johnson denied his involvement, said he didn't know what was in the envelope that he was trying to give Mike Pence, and then pretended to be on a phone call. Yeah, look, I'm sorry, I can't treason right now. I'm on a phone call. Since January 6th, Johnson has peddled conspiracy theory after conspiracy theory, blaming the attack on everyone from Nancy Pelosi to the FBI. Meanwhile, Johnson said he wasn't concerned for his safety because the rioters loved their country. and he would have been concerned if the rioters were from Black Lives Matter. Aside from the obvious racism of that statement, how is it that the rioters were simultaneously patriots, but also involved in a fake coup organized by Nancy Pelosi and the FBI? And how could he address any of this when he's just so busy with his phone calls? Oh, and Johnson is also a tone-deaf jerk. During Johnson's recent debate with Mandela Barnes, the candidates were asked to say something that they find admirable about the other. Barnes said that Johnson was a family man. And after briefly agreeing, Johns asked Barnes why he had, quote, turned against America. Even Fox News reported on how hard Johnson got booed. It's not Johnson's hypocrisy that makes me think he's a terrible senator. It's not his racism or his homophobia. It's not his dangerous conspiracy theories, or his advocating for those who harbor child abusers, or his anti-science viewpoints, or his stance on abortion that seems to have been forged in the 1950s. It's not his trampling of the poor or the elderly or the sick. And it's not Johnson's complete lack of respect for the democratic process. It's all of that, rolled up into one reprehensible human being. All of that adds up to a bigoted man who lives off the teat of his father-in-law, who wants to ensure that you don't ever get the chance to earn what he married into. Of course Johnson is a family man. Without his family, he wouldn't have been able to spend $9 million to buy his way into becoming a senator. If you live in Wisconsin, please ensure that he doesn't get to stay one. Thanks for watching. I'm Steve Hofstetter, and this was for the smart people. Thank you for watching and sharing this video. If you don't already, make sure to follow and subscribe. I'm on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Twitter, and many more, including Patreon. If you join at patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter, you'll see videos like this before anybody else. And once a week, I will post a video exclusively for my patrons. Most importantly, come see me live. I do shows all over the world. If you want to know if I'm going to be performing close to you, go to stevehofstetter.com and find out tour dates and get tickets. See you soon.